Hello guys, I'm so excited to start with this video as we are going to condense 2+ hours tutorial into like 15 minutes easy to grasp tutorial or maybe an inspirational video, not like a straightforward tutorial, okay? This video is brought to you by Squarespace, the ultimate all-in-one solution for creating an incredible website. So, what we're going to do today is like a walkthrough of the process of creating this design. And I'm going to comment on it, say my ideas around why I made some decisions, and we are going to chill with each other, okay? But if you want me to upload the full video, it will just be like 2+ hours me working in a project. Just let me know in the comments and I may be uploaded, okay? So, as always, I'm starting with the sky. I'm saying this all the time because I like to start in a process. I like to think in steps. So, I start with the sky because this is the main source of light. This will put the ambient light around all the subjects into my design and then start to put specific lights or specific light sources, okay? So it's easy to put the sky first and then cast its color, which is most of the time blue color, okay? And then cast its soft lights into objects and then put any other sources of light like the car lights and so on. So the main idea in my mind when creating this design, basically inspired by a man going in a trip in the jungles, okay? And then he suddenly found something very weird, found a ghost in the middle of nowhere, okay? So that's why I love photo manipulation. It enables you to tell stories through images. Just look at the image and let your imagination go wild and think, what is he feeling right now, okay? That was the main idea, okay? So I'm now putting all the images together at first to make a cohesive composition. What is composition? It's basically arranging elements into your visuals to tell specific story. By making a good composition, you are guiding the eye of your audience into the path of thinking into the design. So, for example, when I look at an image like this, what is the main message I want to deliver? Is it this tree, truck, or something? No, of course. Is it the sky itself? Maybe, but it's not the main point. The main point here is the car and then the ghost that we will put later. So this is called focal point. What is focal point? Focal point is basically the most important thing that you want your audience to look at. Okay, after putting elements into its main place, I started to correct two things. The lightness values, which is how dark the elements are. Elements should not have the same lightness values all over the place because the atmosphere affects the lightness because it's coming from basically the sky. We are trying to imitate what happens in nature. In nature, we have atmosphere, which affects the lightness, and it affects it into this way. The further you go in distance, the less contrasty the elements should, and it take from the color of the sky or the source of light, the main source of light, which is, in this case, the sky. That's why I will then put some hazing atmosphere effects later in the video, okay? So what I'm trying to do now is to correct the lightness values and then correcting the saturation, the color of each element to be matching because obviously all the elements should match in terms of colors. And when we are trying to match colors, I want you to be careful of something because all of us, me included, at our beginnings, start to make the design so flat, the colors are
monotone. All the elements have the same color. That's easy. You can easily make one color for the whole design and now it's matching. Just put an overlay of like a blue color, solid color, and now it's matching. That's what I don't want. I want each element to have its unique color, and at the same time, its color should be shifted towards the color of the main source of light, which is the sky. I hope you got this point. And if you don't get it, let me know in the comments so that I may make a full video explaining it. Okay. So I'm now putting the main image of the ghost, which is this woman, and then started to put like a glow effect around it to give it mysteriousness. Okay. So one of the best things that can lead your eye when trying to make a composite like this is how you place the light of some object. So for example, this car is casting its light in purpose into the ghost because I want you to focus on this. So I'm just pointing into the main focal point, which is the ghost, and the light itself is pointing towards it.
Before we go to the next point, let's hear a quick message from today's sponsor, Squarespace. We all know that having a powerful website is crucial for creative individuals like us. Now, I'm not a professional web designer, and honestly, I don't want to spend countless hours trying to create my website from scratch. With Squarespace, all the complex stuff is already taken care of, allowing you to focus on what you do best, unleashing your creativity. One of the things I love about Squarespace is that it's amazing in-browser editor. It enables me to effortlessly create a website by just dragging and dropping some elements. It's literally easier than any design software. But Squarespace offers much more than that. It provides a wide range of features, including email campaigns, powerful blogging tools, and my personal favorite, website analytics, so you can easily track your website's performance. Plus, Squarespace offers loads of modern and solid templates to choose from, ensuring your website looks stunning. Make sure to give Squarespace a try with their free trial. And when you are ready to launch your website, head over to squarespace.com/NourArt to save 10% off your first purchase of the website or domain. I will drop the link in the description below.
And now I'm trying to paint the light using texture brush. Always saying that if you want to have dynamic or not flat lighting, you should use textured brush with the same material of the element that you are painting the light on. Okay. So another tip here, you can use 16-bit color depth into these kind of low light designs because this will give you more flexibility in coloring. Okay. Now, putting some hazing effects using some fog brush, and the transition between the light and the shadow should be a little bit smooth, and at the same time it should be defined and pointing toward the same element. Okay, so using some solid color layers, trying to paint the light with a screen blending mode. Okay, here's another tip I'm using when trying to make the shadows. I always look at the original shadow of an image. For this car, it was having its original shadow, and I can extract it by placing another copy behind this, the main image of the car, after selecting it, and then start it to change its blending mode into multiply and tweak it using levels until I only have the shadow itself. Okay, next, trying to put another color into the design. That's why I started to turn on the lights of the car, which will give the design more spice. Okay, and I used curves to increase the lightness and at the same time change or shift the colors into more of a reddish, orangey color. This enables me to have some texture into the light bulb itself. Then start it to reflect its light into whatever I can feel that the light will fail on. Okay. I like to use texture brushes because I suffered from making flat lightings all the time. And I didn't know what's wrong with the designs. It doesn't look professional. Why I can't paint light as it looks in real life. And after deep analysis, I found out that I'm always painting the light with a very soft brush without any texture in the material. I'm neglecting the texture of the material. This is a very important thing because if you are painting into a very reflective material like a metal, the texture of the light should be soft and it should be shiny. And you will get this by noticing different materials with different lighting falling into it. Okay. At this time, I felt like it's cool, everything is good. The story is missing something because obviously this car is not moving by itself. So we need to add maybe a man or something into the back of the car. Okay, this will make it more interesting. And started to give the horizon some lightness, and at the top section I put this moon. This adds mysteriousness and adds like some horror vibes or something. I don't know how to say it, but it adds to the feeling of the story. Okay, using some overglows and blend F, I blend the moon into the scene. And just make it subtle. Don't overdo it. Okay, so I get this image of this man. So I select it and start to put it inside the car. At this time, I felt like maybe adding this man will not be enough. So I should add some other elements like maybe a tree trunk that is banning the car from getting into the road, or maybe a dog that is running towards the ghost or something. I tried several ideas, but I didn't like how it looks visually, so I just deleted them. And here I noticed that the man is in complete darkness. So I started to give it like a solution. I make a bulb in the car and then started to paint some rim lights into it. This is by design, okay? I'm putting this because I want you to notice him bathing the darkness. So if I didn't draw these lights, you may not notice him, okay? I started to change or tweak the colors using the camera raw filter. This is the final stage. I'm putting the final mode, shifting the colors, shifting the lightness, doing basically everything I feel like it needs. Okay, so here I made it bright because it was very dark and my eye get used to it, so I went to have a drink or something and then get back, and I noticed that it is very dark, so I needed to make it brighter, started to tweak the colors. But I don't know why these days I don't like to shift the original colors that I was working on, so I kept the main colors, the main mode. I didn't shift the colors of the shadows or the highlights, just subtle change. And
that was enough for me.
All right, guys. I don't know if this is something you would like to see more in my channel. Please let me know in the comments. And if you want me to upload the full video of this design, it's going to be like work with me video or something. It will not be narrated. Please let me know in the comments. Yeah, see you soon in next classes. Peace.